Basically, I will be sharing four slides, four content. First is motivation. This will be very minor contents. Second will be how to write. That is basically the improving writing skills in high impact journal papers. Second content will be impact assessment, particularly citation impact, its pros and cons, how to address professionally. And finally, I will be addressing a little bit about ethics, publication ethics. That's also important. Need to be aware, some of the right things, some of the wrong things. So I'll now move to the most important slide, citation impact. So this is the hot cakes, hot things, and most important things you are looking for, you are waiting for. Honestly, I spend significant amount of time to help you, to make you happy based on my experience, based on various SARS and so on. So I'll spend a little bit more time on these things. I think let's not put some limit on the time. As much as I feel I'm satisfied and you are satisfied, this is the most hot topics for you to be talked, particularly for you. I think because writing skill, you already have most in most cases. And this citation impact, basically, many professors, many researchers don't share. And also, to be honest with you, when I try to share this thing, some people also put negative impact because this may entice or attract also some unethical, unfair. So that's why I put what, how to address, how to do all these things in a professional way, because this is very important thing. So some people raise the comment and raise their issues, but whatever, I'm trying to do all this, I try to be as ethical as possible. So that's why I bring pros and cons, negative and positive aspect of the impact assessment. We understand citation is good, but some people say that it has some negative aspects. So I put the all those things here to address pros and cons so that no one can question us. Yes, of course, they can question, but this will be a professional answer. Those who are making some negative remarks, particularly the when Tansi Gao Jasmine posted some of my publication slide, some people make some negative remarks. I was astonished that because this is the thing I want to share. I want to help the participants, audience. Our idea is to share the knowledge. This is, we have our honest purpose, but some people took it differently. This is always will happen, but critical criticism is always welcome. But let's not listen the destructive or negative, those which are not helpful. So I was a little bit shocked, but that's why I put here now how to address the professional. So if those who make all those negative, I think they can understand what is the purpose, our purpose. Our purpose is not to entice something unethical way. Our purpose is to share our knowledge because I'm experienced. I have spent almost 20 years. I have published so many papers. I'm reviewer, I'm editor, I'm so and so. If I don't share all those things with the community, so I think then it is something unfair to the community, okay? So I hope you understand the purpose, okay? Yeah, thank you for your attention. Okay, so first slide is basically is a dream for all of us. As you can see, these are called top-notch journals. As you can see, the highest impact with the cancer journal. Cancer research is really very, very hot topics. I have very good experience with this, and there are some other slides also will tell you cancer research, medical research, maybe now COVID will be one of the hot topics, okay? When you talk about the citations, there are some secret recipes. Basically, I'll be sharing over here. I hope you will find this very, very interesting. So I basically intentionally put these slides to make you to dream yourself. So far, I have not managed to publish any papers here. I made some attempt to submit published in Science and Nature, but again, unfortunately, not successful. But Alhamdulillah, so far, one paper recently published in Materials Horizon, impact factor 14.4. Hopefully, you are trying to publish in Nano Energy. Those are impact factors something like 15. So now I have a target. something like impact factor 10 and above. So that is my target, always trying to raise our bars. Hopefully within next few years, this will be our target. But this is basically for you to dream. Nothing is impossible, but here the rejection rate is very, very high, 90 to 95% rejection rate, but nothing is impossible. So these are called the top-notch journals. So if you can publish, you will be distinguished researcher, you will be invited by many, many universities, distinguished professor, adjunct professor, hello, come and join. For your information, after getting all those awards, constantly I receive. So when I got highly cited research award, actually I have 5 offers. And finally I joined King Fahd University. Nowadays also, I think when I joined Sunway, then also Qatar University also, somebody head of the department called me so many times to join their university. And at the end, I reject their offer because I'm very happy with Sunway University because they gave us our bread and butter for research. So that is very important thing to sustain our research. Okay, so basically this is a top-notch journal. Let's dream in this area. If you can try, nothing harm, nothing wrong. But if you want to publish here, I think you read some of the journal like Science, Nature, and what they published, what are the criteria. I think first you have to understand what should be your content. Okay, so you have to self-motivate yourself. You have to train yourself. I don't have any good experience in writing in this journal. We tried, but we failed. Okay. So maybe next question is, what is the definition of impact factor? Basically, for last 2 years, how many papers published in any specific journal and how many citations? So this is basically the impact factor defined by JCR. You can find this in journal citation report. These are the things also, I don't have enough time. Those who are young researcher, I think you explore using journal citation report. Those who are research university, they subscribe. You log in using your library access card and you can find all those details. So basically it's the definition of how many papers are published for last 2 years and how many total citations. Not each and every, there are some drawback with the citation of the journal only. So I'll be talking in the next slide. So this is a definition of impact factor. Higher is better, but ranking is more important than this impact factor. So these are the reason also you will get some better knowledge. So high impact journal versus paper. Okay. In my view, particularly for authors, researcher, high impact papers are more important than journal because in the journal, some papers are not cited at all. For example, your paper is cited 2000 times. Another paper in another journal was never cited. So then impact factor of their journal is not that important in your case. For example, your paper, impact factor of journal is 4, but your paper has been cited 2000 times. I think your paper 2000 times citation is more important than the journal impact factor. So these are some of the pros and cons sometimes you need to know. So that's what I say, impact factor of an individual paper is more important than impact factor of journal in some cases. But if somebody is a editor of a journal, impact factor of journal is important for him. Some papers are in a journal are not cited at all. I'll give you very specific. That's why I mentioned you, I brought some of the very important analysis and findings. So you can see here, these are very low impact factor journals. I intentionally brought it here, low impact factor, but higher citation. So that's why impact factor sometimes may be immaterial for you. Because what is important for us as an author, how many times cited, how many times our papers are used. As you can see here, impact factor is, this is a Q3 journal, impact factor is 1.703, but 1,082 times cited. It is a highly cited paper, I guess. Okay, you see, huge citation, 1,000 plus, but impact factor is low, it is Q3. So why? So my answer is topic is very important. So that one I will tell you in the later subsequent slides. So these are the hidden recipes I'm going to share with you and it will certainly excite all of you. So second paper, as you can see, it is Q4. effect factor 1.051, but citation is 486. So what is important for you? Definitely citation is important, and why it is cited, even though it is Q4, Q3. Sometimes, you know, these are the drawbacks of the journal. Editor, reviewer are not that strong. Sometimes the editor also not an expert in your topic. So he's just with a shadow or lie, a minor check, he or she rejected your paper. This sometimes make me unhappy also. But what to do? It is hard to convince them. These are the drawbacks of scientific publication. So editors, reviewers are not perfect. They are also human being. So this happens, and your good quality paper is rejected. So it breaks your heart. It is good impact factor, but you could not publish. But you managed to publish at the end in Q3 and citation in so and so. So this is again because of the drawbacks of peer review process, the deficiency of reviewers, deficiency of editors. As you know, sometimes maybe you are very strong in your paper, but reviewers are so poor, because reviewers are selected, as you know, sometimes what happens. So editors, maybe they don't have enough time, they maybe employ someone, they got the reviewer, those who are not qualified, they are not expert like you. So of course, they would put some, you know, some wrong comments. I share one of my experience. So recently, one of the reviewer actually personally communicated with us, because he is an incompetent reviewer. Okay, incompetent reviewer, because he does not have knowledge. So then started to discuss and get some ideas what is actually the content. Okay, again, this is again to share with you, because the reviewers are sometimes incompetent. So what we do in our case, that's why we give the strong rebuttal. Okay, in our case, when you see that this reviewer is a weak, we got the weak point, and then that's how we write a strong cover letter to the editor in chief also specifically to address that this reviewer is not strong enough. But we do it professionally. Anyway, you see the low impact factor here. So again, I'm coming to this slide. Low impact factors, Q3, Q4, but citations are quite high. So this is again, what is important. That's why the topic is important. So in some of the subsequent slides, I'll be sharing why topic is important. So how to improve your citation skills. So that's why topic is important. So when I started my research on household appliances. So I did my master's and PhD. I tried during my PhD to change the topics, but as you know, supervisors are superpower. I cannot go against a supervisor. So again, I agree, and I finished my master's and PhD on household appliances. And when I finished my PhD, so then I am free. So I can do work on industrial energy efficiency. I can work on nanomaterials. That how I changed my topics from household appliances to industrial energy, nanomaterials, solar energy, and that's how my citation from 2008, I had citation of 68 only. And now, as you can see, up to today, it is 32,600 plus. Because why? Because I strategize, I did my homework. I also follow the models of Tansri Gaud Jasmond. He brought from visiting all, the top universities all over the world. This is how, and also I did my homework. I saw my colleague where they published. I saw some of the papers has much more citation than me. Then I start to analyze and why their papers are highly cited. Why not my one? Actually, it was in 2018. And I follow their papers. I follow some strong model. And this is the reason also now my citation is, as you can see, this much. Are you okay with me?
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so I move to the next. Sorry?
Yes, please.
Now you can see citation comparison. I brought here a very important findings here. You see here, the first paper, it is Energy Conversion and Management, and published in 2004. How many citations there? 2,740. Second paper on SolMet, solar energy materials and solar cells. These are Q1 impact factor 6 or 7, something like this. And you see the cited 1,632 times. Now you see the science and nature paper. Can you see the science and nature paper? How many citations of the first nature paper? Anyone can answer?
Citations.
8.03. Okay, thank you very much. Yeah, so you have noticed. So it does not mean that you publish a paper in Science and Nature, it will be cited. There is no guarantee. What is guarantee? If your topic is good, if you design your paper properly, if you write it properly, if you follow some of the guidelines I will give, and certainly that will help you to get your paper cited. Okay, so this is very clear cut that even science papers are not cited. Even nature papers are not cited. So what is important? That one I'm going to share. So this is again motivation for you. Never give up. So you cannot publish in Science and Nature. Never lose your hope. Okay, so there is a journal ranking. I think that's how it is defined by Web of Science. Top 25% in a specific field. So there are 21 fields according to ISI Web of Science. JCR, Journal Citation Reports, Essential Science Indicators. Actually, they are in every field. Let's say there are 100 journals. Among that 100 journal, top 25% is called Q1. And then next 50% is Q2, Q3, and Q4. This is definition of Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4. This is defined by Web of Science. And there is definition of Scopus. Yeah, please do your homework also. This is important for all of you. That's why I brought the specific slides. Ranking, journal ranking is important than impact factor. Why? You see, this journal, Progress in Energy and Combustion Science, its impact factor something like 26. This is a review journal, and it has subtopic, sub-area. So it has thermodynamics, it has energy and fuels, it has engineering, chemical, engineering, mechanical. So in thermodynamics, there are 60 journals. In energy and fuels, there are 103 journals. In chemical engineering, there are 138 journals. In mechanical engineering, there are 129 journals. You can see in thermodynamics, it is number one. So you don't need to compare it with Science and Nature. What we are doing, we are working in our specific field. I am working in energy. Somebody is working in finance. Somebody is working in Islamic finance. Somebody is working on material composite. So in our field, if we are expert, if we are publishing in Q1, if we are number one, I think we should be proud of. And these are the things, particularly those who are students during your promotion, during your interview, you highlight that I am working in this field and my paper is number one. In your candidature defense, you highlight that my paper is number one. You don't need to talk about the Science and Nature, okay, because you could not publish, but still you can highlight that in my field, this is number one. This is Q1. I think this is something we should highlight, we should explore. These are the missing elements. Basically, normally the researchers never share based on my experience. So this is my own analysis. This is my critical analysis. I hope this will be very much useful for you. And use, please use this during your viva, during your promotion, during your interview, wherever possible, with the evidence. Okay, you go in ISI Web of Science, you find this analysis, you get that evidence, you print that, you make it PDF format, and you submit as an evidence. Don't talk without evidence. Okay. Second journal, Energy. It is also top in our area. So I have published, I think, around almost 20 papers. You see, out of in the thermodynamic, there are 60 papers. So it is number three. Again, this is very interesting. So I can speak of that. I have so many papers that rank three in my area. And in the energy and fuels, it is number 15. So again, this is also good. So applied energy, again, you can see. So this is the rank. So this is done by Web of Science. This can be done by, I don't have enough time, but you can explore through JCR, Journal Citation Report, ISI Web of Science, Essential Science Indicators. You can put your name there. You can put the journal name there. Then you can click there. It will show you all the rankings. Okay, so these are some of the information I gave you, but you have to do your homework. If I enter, it will take another half an hour. So time is very limited. Now, how to measure the impact? See, scholarly assessment of impact is basically we have article. So that is basically the citation. Okay, so citation impact will give you your article. Author, again, author we published. So we have H index, we have citation index. Through Web of Science, through Scopus, through Google Scholar. So author indicators are, there are I-10 index, and there are many, many other, but the world recognized one, I think the most difficult one is the ISI Web of Science. So it has a total citation count. It has H index. Google Scholar is the most. It covers each and everything, including conference paper as well, and the Scopus. So these are basically the criteria used to evaluate the author's potentiality. So how many, and also there are, if there are self-citation also nowadays, this can be excluded, this can be included. And this also another measure of how professional you are. If 50% self-citation, again, these are the things can be detected, and in evaluation process, this can be measured. So basically there are impact can be measured for article, author, and the journal. I think for journal, I have mentioned.